1-2, check 1-2. trouble. If a man dies, shall he live again? Jesus answered that question. He said, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And who liveth and believeth in me shall never die. Believest thou this? We brought nothing into this. Jesus Christ to them. Then I negotiated that millions of dollars needed to restore the building. In that building we spent, I remember, more than $5 million. You know who wrote the checks? Carmen. That's the sort of responsibility that she had. And that was so hard because money was taken into the division to pay all of our membership fees in different conditions. And she and Paul Turner handled all of that. Only those two. She was very, very reliable. And someone who could be trusted with millions of dollars. And I never had to guess whether what she was doing was right. Whenever I needed a report, I got it instantly. You should be very proud of her. We have a road there for the leadership of foreign affairs. All of them passed through my hands. They might too. All of them. So I believe I'm one of them. Not all this. Yes, as you can see, praise the Lord for you, brother. Even though you married me, this is a fucking man. I see how old I am. I joined the Ministry of Foreign Affairs in 1974, right after independence. So there were only a couple of people, most of them who were there before me, got all the glory. The first minister was Sir Linda Linden. Was the first foreign minister. Then Paul Madden. Horace Russell. George Stewart. Well, Basil O'Brien is still with us. Idris Reed is still with us. Those are the people who are around in those early days. I tell you one last point about Carmen. When she was getting ready to get married, she called me. I was now in the ministry, and God called me to be in the first place. I was pastor of the church in Kent Road, St. Margaret's Anglican Church. And I got a call from Carmen saying, I need you to do my wedding. I didn't know how time was. She couldn't be your aunt, but I said, you have the best person to do it. The bishop wanted. But she wanted me to go away. That's the photograph that you're looking at. The wedding day came. I said, now, Carolyn, you set the day, and you set the time. Do not be late. Well, why I said that? She has the record of being the latest bride in my history as a priest. She was almost 2 hours late. And her husband, I have the task of keeping him in church. So whenever she leaves, I say, now you can't go nowhere. He had a New York attitude by then. And we don't be down nowhere. You hear about a New York minute? It's a nanosecond. Anyway. I said, buddy, you can't leave. When she came, I did the wedding. And you know what the problem was? She was not late. She was early. I hope the chauffeur of the limo is not yet late. Because if he is yet late, I'll have to apologize to him. The limo driver took on a wedding and funeral. Went to drop the people to the funeral. So he could come and bring the bride to the wedding. That's the first hour. On the way to the church, he had an engine trouble. Well, now you know. You couldn't blame her for that. I couldn't blame her for that. We went on to have a beautiful wedding ceremony. Wonderful, wonderful child. I am even more proud of you.
And she did what she could to help the rules around her. She enjoyed fighting. She did it with energy and zest. She was devoted to her work and demonstrated this by her attendance each day and her confidence in ensuring that the mission's accounts were timely and in order. The Bahamas Permanent Mission to the United Nations, where she gave 34 years of dedicated service, will no longer be the same. She will be sorely missed, and we thank her for her dedicated service. As Father Mutu said, you can be proud of her. She's now passed on,
see.
You were right. You were wrong. You were technical off in a second. You know what she said? Why you want to do no even? Now this is Johnson family. Family. She said, she's the real Johnson. Every Sunday came to church, walked back home, and came back for afternoon Sunday school, and stayed there into the evening, and walked back to Big Four. That is the family that came from Montana Heights. This is a great Bahamian family. Welcome. And this one, after tech. Accident reconstructionist extraordinaire. There was a time when there was no one else, but there was no one else in the Royal House of these force to reconstruct the Italian sea, other than Walter. And Walter was retiring from the Royal House of these force. I said to Walter, where is she? There was a baby. Probably a baby. As a civilian to remain in the world of the Royal House of these force. That's a contribution this family has made and continued making to our country. And so today I extend on behalf of Valerie, my wife, our children, and I take license on behalf of our beloved Pastor Bishop, who's out of the jurisdiction, and this church here issued to extend to the Johnson family my friends, condolences, and to let you know that our prayers are with you. We thank God for the years, 58 years, that He's allowed our sister, our friend, to be a part of us. And let me say together to our ladies today, pray yourself, a little bit of all of us, who grow to that youth, will go into the whole world. And a bigger portion of us will remain
brings something for everyone. And she don't wait for us to go to her. She will drive to every single one of her brother's souls. And even if she can give you a pack of t-shirts or a pack of boxes, she's coming and she's bringing it in. Wherever she comes wearing down and she comes bearing, never come with her hands straight. I said, Carly, by your family, she came.
Behold, I tell you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed in a moment, in a twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet. For the trumpets will sound, and the dead will be raised incorruptible, and we shall all be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible has put on immortality, has put on incorruption, and this mortal has put on immortality, then shall be brought
So they can go before the God, go through. Because there is a brighter side. There's another side to life. And this is eternal life. We thank the Lord for our sister. She's left that legacy. And she beckons us from eternity to come and be with her. We are ready for this video presentation.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
We are the soldiers. Out of it. Don't get involved. is not to live for God. Live for God. Live. Let your light shine before Him, that He can see your good works and glorify your Father, which is in heaven. My sister, live. Let her light shine. That's why the light she lives now speaks for her. And that's what it's all about. Let them. Get another light. Thank you. But their life, they were on heroes. But their life impacted so many people. I said, Where did she do that? They didn't watch it. It was how you did it. Until the Lord blesses. Please, I support you. We are the small thing. What are you doing on earth for heaven's sake? Are you doing for yourself and your family? That's what you do. Don't get over one. You can get over one. And some of the churches calling you over one. God is going to give us one reward for what we do out there. How we treat our brothers and sisters. How we treat our neighbor. How we deal with out there.
Dissolving every day.
And one of these days, we may not succumb to it because our boundary would have been set and we cannot cross over. And so, Father, let us know that we cannot escape. For as your word says, how shall we escape if we neglect so great a salvation? There is no escape other than through Jesus. All other escape is sinking sand. And there is no foundation in the sinking sand. And so, God, Father, just where they may be, those that are being touched by your word through your Holy Spirit, help them to make that commitment. And our dear sisters, from this day forward, I'm going to treat people right. I'm going to live right for you. I'm going to, oh God, live for you so that I can, when the trumpet sound and it sounds so loud, that I will rise or I will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet you in the air. And so bless the family today, the Johnson family and the Roll family, God. And you will strengthen them. A gem out of their family has been taken. You have taken a gem, a beautiful rose, out of their family to be planted in your garden, your garden. And so, God, help them to remember the good times, a legacy, what you stand for, what you believe in, and what you live for.
Cemetery to the burial site, and we're asking as many of you as possible to participate in this last time of this grand fellowship with our sister and friend, Coralyn Johnson. Marie family, you can stand now, please. Mahama Brass Band.
Thank you. punting at the graveside. Okay. What's up? I make sure I tell my clients I don't own the telephone company, internet companies. So if it goes down, they'll get a recording. Let me press recording.
Thank you. thank you very, very much. Naked came I from my mother's womb. And the Lord give it and the Lord take it. Blessed be the name of the Lord. For none of us liveth unto himself, and no man dieth unto himself. For whether we live unto the Lord. And whether we die unto the Lord. So whether we live or die, for this end Christ both died and rose and revived, that he might be Lord both of the dead and of the living. Today we've gathered to pay our final respect and our committed service. I want to invite Minister Sammy Johnson. He's going to give us the opening prayer, and then we'll go from there. Minister Johnson.
Shall we reverence this moment in prayer? Our Father and our God, the creator of the heavens and the earth, the giver of life, we assemble here today with grateful heart and praise as we reflect and celebrate the life of your gift to us, Coraline. And Father, we come this place, dear Father, to bid our farewell. She has lived a life, dear Father, and she has fought her fight, dear Lord, and she has completed her race. Yes. And we stand, dear Father, as testimony of a life lived for you, Lord. We appreciate your goodness and your favor upon her. You have favored her, dear Lord, with a job. You have favored her, Father, with a husband. You have favored her, Lord, with a son. You have favored her with a fine family and great friends. And Father, we all gather in celebration and praise for the work, dear Father, she has done. And may her work, Father, speak for her. Oh God, we pray your comfort upon us gathered here. You, the God of all comfort, have your way with us today. Let your will be done in this ceremony, Lord. We pray, Father God, that whatever is said and done be said and done to your honor and to your glory. We lift up your name today. We magnify your name today. And we give you all the honor, all the glory, all the praise, because you do it all things well. We know, Father God, that our sister, Lord, will rise again, Lord. This is not the end, for death to the believer is but a transition, Lord. Oh God, we appreciate you, Father. Yes, her living was not in vain. If I could but help somebody as I travel along, then my living shall not be in vain. Coraline's living was not in vain. And we say thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Son.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Holy Ghost. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Can somebody say praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
You can do better than us. Say praise the Lord.
Praise.
Opening song, It Is Well. When peace like a river attended my way. When sorrows like sea billows rule, whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to sing, it is well, it is well with my soul. Come, Pastor T. It is well. Come, son.
When peace like a river attended my way.
When sorrows.
When sorrows.
Whatever my lot,
whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to sing, it is well, it is well with my soul.
Oh, it is well.
It is well with my soul.
that Christ has regarded.
That Christ has regarded.
All my helpless
is my helpless
state. And I've shared his own
blood.
Pastor Green, our dear beloved Bishop Hannah, and our pastor, Minister Terrence Forbes, and all of God's wonderful people that are here present. For our conversation is in heaven, from whence also we look for the Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ, who shall change our vile body, that it may be fashioned like unto his glorious body, according to the working whereby he is able even to subdue all things unto himself. Martha said unto him, I know that he shall rise again in the resurrection at the last day. Jesus said unto her, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live, and whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. Believest thou this? Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? Nay, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him that loveth us. For I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God which is in Christ Jesus, our Lord. For we know that if our earthly house of this tabernacle were dissolved, we have a building of God, a house not made with hands, but eternal in the heavens. For in this we groan earnestly, desiring to be clothed upon with our house which is from heaven. If so be that being clothed, we shall not be found naked. For we that are in this tabernacle do groan, being burdened, not for that which would be unclothed, but that clothed upon, that mortality might be swallowed up in life. Flesh shall perish and return again unto the dust, and the dust shall return to the earth, as it was, but the Spirit shall return to God who gave it.
Therefore, we commit this body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. We await the glorious return of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who is coming with power and great glory. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, as we come once again before your throne, we thank you. We thank you for this occasion. We thank you for our sister and the life that she had lived for you, God, these 40, these 58 years. We give you all the honor and all the glory. You do not do nothing wrong. You do not make a mistake. What you does is well done. And so, God, we say thank you. We praise you even in our grief and in our sorrow and in our pain. God, we say thank you because your word tells us that in all things, in death or life, we must give you thanks. And so bless the family, the son, the husband, the siblings, the aunt, the nieces and nephews, all the family members of this family, that you will bless them, comfort them. God, the days, the months, the weeks, and the years is going to be rough for them. But God, help them to know that you promise that you will never leave them nor forsake them. You will be there when those lonely times come. You will be there, God, to take them through when the difficult time comes. And so, God, bless the family. Strengthen and keep the family. We ask, oh God, all of these favors and blessings in no other name but in the resurrection name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, whom we look to come at any moment now to take us to himself in glory, in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Bishop, as we have the flower tribute by the family. I want us to sing this song, City of Gold, as the family come to pay their final tribute.
There's a city of light, let it come into night. There's a city of beauty untold.
All my treasures,
all my treasures
are there, and its beauty I share.
When I get to the city of gold,
when I leave,
and I leave this old world, troubles and care, I will say with rejoicing, good morning up there. I will have greatest glory, gladness and joy, when I get to that world city of gold.
In
a
city so fair,
I know safeness yet enter to. Shadows all I love, and the friends I've known, when I get to the city of gold. Oh, and I need this old world, troubles and care, I will say of gold.
Won't you come, go with me?
Won't you come there with me?
To the home of the free.
Of the free.
Won't you see
heaven's beauty untold?
Then
you will come along. We'll sing heaven's song. When we get to that city of gold.
When I leave.
When I leave this old world. Oh, I will say good morning up there. I will have great gladness when I get to
gratitude going to be expressed by Bethel brothers, and then we'll have Woodlawn Gardens also to have words of gratitude.
My family and friends, Sister Coraline is like the great hymnologist. When he wrote in consolation to his soul, I'm free, praise the Lord, I am free. I'm no longer bound, there's no more chains holding me. My soul is resting, and it's just a blessing. Praise the Lord, hallelujah, I'm free. Special thanks to Bishop Morse, Bishop Hannah, Reverend Green, Pastor Forbes, other associate ministers of the gospel, and to you, my beloved friends. For the family has asked me to say thank you to all of you. For your cards, your letters, and your prayers were gratefully accepted, and you all will be thanked in a more personal manner at a later date. Until that morn, we, the management and staff of Bethel Brothers, Morticians, and Crematoriums, would like to leave these words with you. Although her smiles have gone forever, and her hands you cannot touch, yet you'll have those precious memories of your mother, wife, sister you love so much. Each time you'll see a picture, for it seems to smile and just say, don't cry from only sleeping. We'll meet again someday. And may God's never-ending love and mercies rest remain henceforth now and forevermore. This is our prayer in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
I want to invite you, please, to bow your head and thank the Lord for the life of our dear sister. And indeed, she will be greatly missed. I want to invite you to please just bow your head just for a moment and a final word of prayer. Father, we give you thanks, O God, for the life of your daughter. We thank you, O God, for the example that she has shared among family. She's a lover of you, God, and a lover of family. Father, we ask, O God, that you would strengthen this family, O God, in the times ahead. We ask, O God, that your grace and peace, O God, be multiplied unto them. Lord, we give you thanks, O God, for your faithfulness towards the Roll and the Johnson family. And Father, we thank you, O God, for what you have done. And we give you praise for all that you have done and continue to do. And our grace, mercy, peace, and the love of the Father may rest and remain with this family, both henceforth, now, and forever. And let the family say,
amen.
Come on, let the family say one more time.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Yeah.
to a rush funeral, but they're having a couple more funerals coming, and they asked if you want to get out now because it may be a little while before you would be able to.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for being with us. Blessings, honor, and peace.
Alison was there.
Hey.